Alright, boys. That's nice. Gonna be right back. Just had to close the window. Decent hand, I would say. War cry a million. That's exactly the card you want to see, not sadness. I'm the saddest panda now. Why the fuck does my opponent play Grenadin and Skycrack on turn 1 against me when I wanna try this? And this is the hand I get, wow. The sadness is real. That's annoying, but I mean we still have a 4-4 quick draw that he might not have an answer to. Quick draw endurance, so no permafrost nonsense. I guess we had. Cause he has everything. That's weird. Wrecked. Whoop whoop. Let's shuffle. Whoop 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 whoop. Let's see if we can do better. It's a bit of an awkward deployment. That's not better, but not really worse either. Yeah, I should have actually, like, blocked. Oh well. Was still a decent trade for us, though. Might need the weapon gaining 3 drop after all, not sure. Pew pew. Boom boom. Not like I care about blocking at 25. That's annoying. But we got this guy. Pew pew! Not so bad. Not gonna block. If he attacks there, he has something. Like, I don't know. Rock slide or nonsense. Or torch. More shuffle. Woo, 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 woo. This artwork looks really nice, this big. Pretty cool. Pew, 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 pew. The new occupation during like queue time is shuffling these cards around. Like, look at this, like, whoop, whoop, whoop. I mean, we draw extra cards and we still don't get there, like, wow. Gonna need this for this guy. Okay, zero cost Titan is not fun. I don't think we can win here anymore. Power screwed for way too long against a deck like this. Not fun.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Oh, does it show you that? Oh, nice. One drop! Hype! This hand looks decent. That's not good for us. I'm fairly sure it isn't, because that would be like way too on the nose. I think the continue is because I get a pause there. Exactly, that's because I have a torch. That makes a lot more sense. A few more weapons than I'd like. Wait, it does that every time you play or you play a weapon on it. This card is so much better than I thought even. Like, this card is insane. Like, this card is incredible. This card is insane. How is this card so good? Jeez. Ripperonis. This card is unreal! They're not high. I think we just don't need Peacekeepers brought in the end. Oh, hello! I think somebody's dead. Oh shit! We need to change how we build the stack a bit. I kind of completely blanked on that. This guy is insane! Like, legit nuts! Wow. I want my scepters back in here. No, no. Scepter! Come on, baby. Also makes the deck screwless, which was pretty nice. Not sure how much I like Elder's Feather. Brittany, I mean, guy is also used as a term for both. And I'm not gonna like check whether it's a female or a male character in the card to determine whether I say guy or girl. It's just guy as in guys, as in how you would address a mixed group, like whatever. Somebody is triggered. This guy is insane. Hmm. Oh, rip. Like, this card might be ultimately worse than Outlaw. I mean, it has kind of a nice ceiling. Like, really good with this thing. Let's try Outlaw, maybe. I wonder if Elder's Feather is better than Katana. The fact that it costs one is pretty huge though with this and this guy. Yeah, definitely not the charge Jedi. But we might be close to like only Weapon Master territory here, but I think that might just be like a bit too value oriented for how aggressive the deck is. But I'm like this close to playing like fucking Spiked Helm. There's a 5 drop, yeah. But that's not what we are in the business for. That's not how we roll here. Hey, Sleepy Lion. What I dislike is the tension between... What I dislike is the tension between Scepter and our mostly Justice 1-drops. And Infantry, I think, is just so much better in this deck than Pyronite. Also, by the way, I think it actually says fight, and then when I play my my combat trick, it says continue or something, not sure. We'll pay attention to it. But the way you guys described it seems very abusable, so I'm skeptical if it works that way. Because you have to at least be able to, like, read pauses rather than just be told, like, okay, your opponent has a fast spell. Like, even before you use your fast spell, you're supposed to see it only when you use yours. Please don't die, 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 please don't die. I mean, it's a reasonable chance that it won't die because he didn't have something turn one. So he might just play a 2-drop here. Yes! Sometimes lucky! I think I, gonna scepter here. Instead of torching and doing stuff, and next turn we like torch and finest hour and shit. At least we have two units now. Even if he has a permafrost. And got like Warcry and damage lead. That's good. And we have Warhelm for like the Warcry target that we draw. That was kind of bad, I should not have done that. That was terrible. That was so bad. Why did I not ignore this guy? That was terrible. Should have just attacked. Really, really bad. Or like, god awful. Might, like, so bad that it might cost us the game. But we will see. If we ever draw, like, the thing that got about 8 Warcries, we're just gonna win with this Warhelm. I kind of expected that. Give Warcry target now. Warhelm to the win. Come on, all weapon. Oh yeah! Oh yeah! BAM! I like this deck already. I'm not sure how good it's gonna be. It's definitely not bad and it's a lot of fun. BAM! I mean, this wins through so much, like, it's a fucking 11-10 charge that exhausts the best blocker. It's like, wow. Hey, Gresham's. You back for the resub, my man. Vadio's artwork is really nice. It's a pretty cool artwork. Really like it. It's like this weird Indian Eskimo cowboy. No. Like, this 2-drop is blowing my mind. 2-drop level insane. Insane in the membrane. Oh, Sarius. So he's on, like, Feln, Nightfall, aggro, tempo, nonsense. Although I think his list is pretty awfully built because he runs, like, 8 4-drops. If you still read chat, if you still listen to the stream, Sarius, yes, running Impending Doom and the new 2-drop in something that you, for some reason, decided to call Feln Tempo is terrible, as in god awful. Like, why would you do that? Like, 8 4 drops in an aggressive deck is so bad on so many levels. I don't even know. I think what we want to do is this, this, and this, and then fuck Zarius very deeply into his butt and show him that 8-4 drops no tempo, 8-4 drops very dead, especially with these two in our hand. Whoop whoop, that's cute. Also, I think our deck very much appreciates drawing cards. He's getting fucked! The night is dark and full of terrors, you know? No! Fuck. The night is dark and full of terrors. For the night is dark and full of terrors. Somebody is pretty dead. That's cute. But you're dead, son. Letting the aggro deck draw extra cards. Not so good. That's good, but not good enough, son. Oh shit. 7, 10, 14. I think that does the trick. Pew pew! This is so ridiculous. I love this deck. And it legit is like budget as fuck. This deck is so dumb. It's nice that we get to see these artworks in like nicer and bigger. I also don't think you want to be like too aggressive with this like Nightfall deck. You want to go like Fallen Tempo style in a way. Is Zarius still watching? Yeah, he is. I mean, he deserved it, I'd say. His 2-drop, this 1-drop is so sweet! Whoop whoop! Hello. Somebody else is getting butt-fucked real hard. Like, I mean, the Warcry is also so insane in this deck. Like, we can play a deck that stops at 3, but scales so well into the game with like a million Warcry, it's amazing. I love it. I think not playing Outlaw is just basically always wrong. Sort of. Gonna play this, cause this one is gonna get vanquished, so... So I'll play this one first. I mean, maybe I was bad. Maybe I should have just played it and hope he doesn't have Vanquish, because if he doesn't, this basically fucks him. Everything. Thanks for the host, Notorious. Hello everyone coming over from Notorious. We are kicking ass with Rakano Gunslingers. Oh, hello. Ah, oh, we can't play it. Fuck. We basically just need a fire source on this. Like, if we had fire this, like, double fire this turn, we would be so far ahead that we win the game. Because then we could just attack, he was would be forced to jump. That's, like, pretty nasty now. I mean, not sure if OP, but they look pretty good. But we're gonna lose now. We're having fun with Rakano Gunslinger aggro. But now we are losing because we kind of, like, got stuck on tempo. The good old overstated combre curve can stop you.
While with a world in motion, bridges over every ocean, why I'm running wild. So flood of ages.
Yeah, that guy is pretty sweet. That was a perfect top deck, basically. Wow. Our draw really needed this. That's okay.
Back around.
Bam! I think I like this a bit better than Marshall here. Rather do Marshall next turn. I think I don't want to, like, run into a trick here.
You messed with the wrong girl.
I don't want to attack with this turn, still a bit too risky for us. I guess I could have attacked with it because it forces him to block for sure. But yeah, now we just win. Doesn't even matter. I mean, this 2-drop is so insane, like, it's Cinder Yeti on steroids, absurd. Can't believe how good this card is. This is incredible. Like, even mono fire aggro with this guy is gonna be good. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. That's a bit of an awkward hand. Bit floody. At least we have enough power for our one drop, like, and power for days. That's good. Being on the draw does not help our... Really fucking really, like, what the fuck is this? Salt. Salt of the earth. The salt is real. Okay, now I just give up, like. Yep. 7 by turn 3. I guess that's how you lose. We are basically dead, but that's life.
Just keep moving.
Hello everybody, this is Manuel.
I don't like this card in Skycrack much. Skycrack doesn't have enough good weapons. Unless you add Warham, then it might be okay-ish. I wanna like reduce the stats by like the games with the initial version that was definitely flawed. So let's play 4 more with this version to have 10 games with this version, cause it's vastly different from the first one. That's a sweet hand. But yeah, I guess, I mean, it might be that Skycrack Aggro just benefits more from the 2-drop in the end. And finally makes it worth it to play crappy Katana. I mean, in Rakano we get the 3-drop and like Steady Marshal and like another cheap weapon that has evasion and Finest Hour, so it's a close call possibly. I think we might try Yetis next. At least brew it and see how it looks. Because, I mean, the thing is, it's 4 legendaries that I need to craft for it, so that's kind of a big commitment dust-wise. If the deck turns out bad. Because, like, it's a very narrow card, like the Yeti 5 drop, a Yeti 4 drop is only good in Yetis, and if Yetis is good, the card is really good, and if Yetis is not good, I craft 4 legendaries for nothing. In a situation where I don't have enough dust to craft everything. That's a kind of a good hand. Yeah, that's pretty brutal. Choo choo, Bradykin. Let's see what he's cooking. Probably with gas like everyone else, but we'll see what. What's in the pot? Trying to crack a nut without spilling like the whole shell of the nut through my entire room. He's on Fallon control? Nope, he's not. Just keep moving. He is not. Clearly not Fallon control. It's written right here. I think this is the best line. Ah, got it. But I crushed a nut inside. That sucks. Why is this so hard? Then you bite on a shell. But freshly cracked. Hazelnuts are so awesome. Okay, so basically we stun this. Then we like play this. That's gonna be a nice next turn. I mean, it's almost lethal, I think. Like, it's 7, 11, 1 power off, but we can win next turn under CS Harshwell. Which he might be playing. Nope, that's not good enough. Somebody is very dead. But yeah, Behemoth is a nice alternative to Marshall, I guess, in some way, because it's much better board impact. And ramps without power in hand. And still ramps really aggressively. So yeah, this version doing pretty good. I like where this is going. Not the greatest hand once again, but why would you do that? That makes no sense. I mean, you can just control brew yourself also. we do this, we kill him in like 3 turns. And he has no good outs to this, so I guess we just do this. Pew! And this will threaten to block the 4-2. Anyway. Oh, this guy is winning. Like, he basically needs obliterate or double spell. After he double torched, it's unlikely he can double spell this. That's okay.